Honolulu in 1932 became the focus of international attention when mainland socialite Grace Fortescue was arrested for murder along with her son-in-law, Navy Lieutenant Thomas Massey, and two of his friends. The victim, 22-year-old Joseph Kahahawai Jr., had been shot to death. A few months earlier, Kahahawai and four other young men were charged with a gang rape of Thomas Massey's wife, despite the fact that several witnesses placed them at a party in town at the time Thalia Massey claimed she was abducted in Waikiki. Although she told police she could not identify her attackers, when the suspects were paraded before her on several occasions, her memory improved. But the jury in the trial of the five men could not reach a verdict. That's when the killers abducted Kahahawai, drove him to Grace Fortescue's rented home in Manoa, and shot him. They were speeding toward the blowhole to dump his body in the ocean when police stopped their car. Despite the best efforts of Clarence Darrow, America's most famous criminal defense attorney, the jury convicted Mrs. Fortescue, Thomas Massey, and his two friends. In Washington, Congress was outraged that four white people would go to prison for killing a native Hawaiian. So President Herbert Hoover ordered the territorial governor to free the killers. Reluctantly, Governor Lawrence Judd reduced their 10-year prison sentences to just 1 hour served sitting in his office at Iolani Palace. The Masseys, Mrs. Fortescue, and the two Navy men left Hawaii almost immediately. Joseph Kahahawai Jr. was carried to his final resting place in a cemetery alongside School Street in Kapalama.